My name is Marije Groen, and I'm very happy to welcome Daniel Peru to talk about emerging and frontier market impact bonds. Daniel is Global Head of Business Development at Blue Orchard Finance, a leading impact investor and a subsidiary of Schroders. Daniel, welcome. It's great to have you here.
Thank you, Marije.
Now, before we start talking about the opportunities that we see in emerging markets, would you mind briefly introducing Blue Orchard to our Dutch listeners who might be a bit less familiar with impact investing?
Sure. So Blue Orchard was founded in Geneva in 2001 around the management of a microfinance fund aiming at supporting the growth of microfinance institutions in emerging countries. As a firm, we want to foster financial inclusion in frontier and emerging markets where access to finance is still limited for a large share of the population. Since last year, we are part of the Schroders Group, which has a strong and long-term commitment to sustainability. Our headquarters are in Zurich, but the vast majority of our staff is based in emerging countries where we have offices, Lima, Nairobi, Singapore, and Tbilisi. As mentioned, our core business has remained microfinance, but we have expanded our platform with private equity, infrastructure, and also in the liquid part with the launch of the UCITS Impact Bond Fund. Our investment philosophy is to analyze any investment opportunity with two lenses. One is the financial performance, and the other, at the same level, is the social and environmental performance. So in essence, Blue Orchard is entirely dedicated to impact investing with an exclusive focus in emerging markets.
Now let's talk current affairs, Daniel. How have investors reacted since the start of the pandemic? Are they still interested in impact finance?
Yes, so our client base has been resilient despite the severity of the crisis, and I would definitely confirm that impact investing as mega trend is here to stay. The main driver for the growing interest in impact investing is obviously largely driven by the millennials who want really to express their values through their investments. Mm. In our view, the firm willingness to fight against poverty and climate change has definitely not changed because of the coronavirus. Mm.
Now, what we definitely can see is that COVID-19 has increased the inequality in society, and it seems more important now than ever to be able to integrate social impact into investment decisions. What role do you think that social impact bonds can play in emerging and frontier markets in addressing these social imbalances?
Yes, this is an unprecedented global health crisis with severe consequences for economies. In our view, this will put financial inclusion even more in the spotlight of both public and private investors. And we have recently received numerous requests from institutions to finance their growth, and for investors seeking impact, the support of this growth in local economies via the financing of financial institutions is a very powerful rationale. And the pandemic has also led to the launch of a number of so-called corona bonds or COVID-19 bonds aiming to mobilize capital to fight the pandemic and its negative social consequences. And we think that some of these bonds offer value and high impact.
Hmm. Now, I know that Blue Orchard manages its own emerging markets impact bond fund. Can you maybe tell us a bit more about the strategy from a risk return and also an impact perspective of this fund?
Sure, Maria. So the fund has three main characteristics. It is focusing on emerging markets impact bonds and is UCITS compliant. It is a crossover strategy. So the fund will always have an average IG rating, but we will look from AAA to single B credit ratings. It is a benchmark agnostic and has very limited overlap with traditional indices. The main drivers for the launch of the fund are twofold. And the first one is the observation that in the microfinance industry, larger institutions start to issue bonds to finance themselves. So they no longer only rely on the private markets. And we felt that this trend might be accelerating in some of the more mature markets for microfinance. And so these are interesting investment opportunities to capture both from a financial, but also from a social impact perspective. The second reason for the launch of the fund is obviously on the investor side and the increasing demand from retail investors who could not access the microfinance fund because this is only for qualified investors.
Right. Now, you're already mentioning some of the opportunities. Can you specify a bit more what the opportunities of this fund are?
Yes. So basically, what we are looking at is really financing financial institution in emerging and frontier markets and buying bonds and offering a very diversified portfolio to investors looking for impact. Mm-hmm.
So I understand that the bond also invests in a social bond from the International Finance Corporation, correct? Which is part of a collaborative response to the COVID-19 pandemic. Can you tell us a bit more? Is this a typical example of an investment that's creating tangible impact alongside the specific SDGs?
Yes, this definitely represents a great example of a portfolio holding. But what is really important to underscore here is the diversity of issuers and bonds that we have been thoroughly analyzing and selecting for this portfolio with the objective to maximize impact, taking return and liquidity into consideration. So to give you two other examples of portfolio holdings, we, for example, hold the first social bond issued by an African corporate company providing inclusive and responsible financial solutions to individuals and small companies across Africa and LATAM. We also hold, for example, one bond from a leading Indonesian microfinance financier.
So you mentioned already liquidity, which is obviously an important thing to investors, I can assume. How important is it to combine financial and social returns with liquidity?
Yes, so having a UCITS liquid product really allows us to initiate the democratization of impact investments towards private investors. As mentioned earlier, that was also one of the main driver for the launch of this product is that we've seen in the market increasing demand from retail investors who wanted to do impact but couldn't do it because they are not qualified investors. And so the UCITS is really addressing this problem.
And how does the bond actually target the sustainable development goals, the SDGs?
Yes. So the fund will purchase mainly bonds issued by EM financial institutions with a proven social and environmental impact and an alignment to the achievement of the SDGs. The fund aims at contributing to the closing of the investment gap while creating really tangible impact along specific SDGs, which is number one, no poverty, number seven, affordable and clean energy, number eight, decent work and economic growth, nine, industry, innovation and infrastructure, and 10, reducing inequalities.
And how do you then determine whether a bond actually qualifies as a social impact bond?
Yes, so Blue Orchard has adopted a procedure to evaluate whether bond issuance meets all Blue Orchard social and environmental eligibility criteria to be part of the investment universe. And the procedure is focused on issuances and not on issuers and is relevant for the impact assessment of green bonds, SDG bonds, sustainability bonds. And the industry standards that we adopted are defined by the International Capital Market Association, ICMA, who produced a set of widely accepted principles for each of the type of bonds I've mentioned.
And I hear that you also, Blue Orchard at least, also has a tool that they use to, it's called Spirit, is my understanding. How does this tool work? Can you explain a bit more about it?
Yeah, sure, Myron. So Spirit stands for Social Performance Impact Reporting and Intelligence Tool. The Bond Spirit was developed by adapting the original financial inclusion spirit tool that we use for our microfinance fund. And so the Bond Spirit captures and analyzes the social performance practices and associated impact. And the tool has been really developed in the form of a questionnaire, including six categories aligned with the social performance task force universal standards for social performance management. So it's really based on this proprietary tool that we use in the private markets that today we can really analyze any issuer and in any bond with this Bond Spirit.
Thank you, Daniel. I would like to thank Daniel Perroux, Global Head of Business Development at Blue Orchard Finance, for his insights. This interview about impact investing is offered to you by Schroders. It was recorded as part of the Impact Week of Fonds News. For more interviews on impact investing, please visit fondsnews.nl.
Belangrijke informatie. De mening en standpunt in deze video zijn die van Daniel Perroux en zij vertegenwoordigen niet noodzakelijk de meningen die worden uitgedrukt of weerspiegeld in andere berichten, strategieën of fondsen van Schroders. Deze video is uitsluitend bedoeld ter informatie. De video is niet bedoeld als aanbod of uitnodiging om een financieel instrument of effect te kopen of te verkopen of een bepaalde beleggingsstrategie te volgen. De verstrekte informatie vormt geen beleggingsadvies, beleggingsaanbeveling of beleggingsonderzoek en is niet afgestemd op de specifieke omstandigheden van enige ontvanger. Het materiaal is niet bedoeld als financieel, juridisch of fiscaal advies en mag niet worden gebruikt als basis hiervoor. De vermelde informatie wordt geacht betrouwbaar te zijn, maar de juistheid of volledigheid wordt door Schroders niet gegarandeerd. Schroders is niet aansprakelijk voor onjuistheden in feiten of meningen. De opvattingen en informatie in deze video mogen niet worden gebruikt als basis voor individuele beleggingsbeslissingen en of strategische beslissingen. In het verleden behaalde resultaten zijn geen betrouwbare leidraad voor de toekomstige resultaten. De koersen van de aandelen en de daaruit gegenereerde inkomsten kunnen zowel dalen als stijgen en het is mogelijk dat beleggers het oorspronkelijk geïnvesteerde bedrag niet terugkrijgen. Deze video geeft de meningen en opvattingen van Schroders weer. Deze kunnen veranderen. Schroders is een datacontrole met betrekking tot uw persoonsgegevens. In ons privacybeleid dat u kunt raadplegen op www.schroders.com/en/privacy-policy vindt u informatie over de wijze waarop Schroders uw persoonsgegevens kan verwerken. Als u geen toegang hebt tot deze website is ons privacybeleid op aanvraag verkrijgbaar. Uitgegeven door Schroders Investment Management Europe, SE 5, Reu Heuenhof, L1736, Senningerberg, Luxemburg. Registratienummer B37799. Ter behoeve van uw veiligheid kunnen telefoongesprekken worden opgenomen of beluisterd.